So can you fill the blank here? So I write as 2 plus blank is equal to 2. So what is the value placed in the blank? Very good, 0. Why? So when you have the 0 with the number, it gives the same number. Okay. So can you fill with 3 plus blank is equal to 3? 3 plus blank is equal to 3. So what is the number? We can finish the fill that. Again 0. Very good. Again 0. Okay. So by observing these two, so what we can do is that, so when you add at the 0 with any number, the result will be the same. So when you add the 0 with any number, the result will be same. So that means here we say that, so 0 is the, 0 is the 82. So 0 is the 82 identity. 0 is the 82 identity over addition. 0 is the 82 identity over addition. Okay. So next up. So can you fill the blank? So 3 into blank that gives the result as 3. So in that blank, so which number satisfied? Okay, very good. 1. So 3 1 that gives 3. Okay. So can I take 7 into blank is equal to 7? 7 into blank is equal to 7. Can you fill that? Okay, so again 1. Very good. 7 1 that 7. So by observing the two examples, we conclude that. So when you multiply any number with 1, when you multiply any number with 1, the result will be same. When you multiply any number with 1, the result will be same. Okay, so that means here 1 is called multiplicative identity over multiplication. Okay, so 1 is called multiplicative identity. Okay, so here come back, what is 0? What is 82 identity? So 0 is the 82 identity. Why you are called 0 is the 82 identity? When you add 0 with any number, the result will be same. Okay, so that's why 0 is the 82 identity. So what is multiplicative identity? So multiplicative identity is 1. Why? Because when you multiply any number with 1, the result will be same. Okay, so those are the identities. So next, so can you fill the blank? Can you fill? Okay, so after that 2 plus blank is equal to 0. So can you fill the blank? So what is the value of the blank? Very good, minus 2. Very good, minus 2. So 2 of minus 2 is equal to 0. So can you fill with the blank here? Minus 7 plus blank is equal to 0. So how can I get the sum of two numbers as 0? So what is the value here? 7. Very good. Minus 7 and plus 7 gives you 0. First of all, so 84 plus blank is equal to 0. So what is the number here? The result will be 0. Very good. Minus 4. Plus 4 and minus 4 gives you 0. So can you observe anything, any point on these those three examples? Okay, so let me take that. Here I am taking 2. So 2 is the first, suppose A. So I am taking A. So what is the resultant value? We got the 0 by using minus A. So by using minus A, that means the sum of the value we give is 2. When we take the A, so the it will add up to the minus A. So that means here 82 inverse of, so these two are called 82 inverses. So 82 inverse of 2 is minus 2. So what is the 82 inverse of minus 7 here? Very good, plus 7. 82 inverse of minus 7 is 7. So what is the 82 inverse of 4? 82 inverse of 4 is minus 4, because 82 inverse is using sum of the two numbers gives the result as 0. So then those two numbers is called 82 inverse of the both two numbers. Okay, this is about 82 inverse. So next discuss about multiplicative inverse. Awesome. Any idea? No idea. Okay. So when you remember one point, when you multiply number with their reciprocal, it gives the value as 1. When you multiply any number with their reciprocal, it gives the value as 1. Okay, that means what is the reciprocal of 7? So reciprocal of 7 is 1 by 7. So reciprocal 7 is 1 by 7. That means the blank will fill with 1 by 7. The blank will fill with 1 by 7. So that means here 1 by 7 is called multiplicative inverse of 7. Multiplicative inverse of 7. So again, fill with, now suppose we have 2 by 3 into dash is equal to 1. So what the value? Fill in the blanks. Okay, so easy. So when you multiply any number with their reciprocal, it gives the value as 1. Okay, so when you multiply any number with their reciprocal, it gives 1. Okay, that means here 2 by 3 into what the reciprocal of 2 by 3? Reciprocal. So reciprocal means reversing. Reversing the numbers. Okay, reciprocal. So 2 by 3, reciprocal 2 by 3 is 3 by 2. 2 by 3 reciprocal is 3 by 2. So that means so, here 3 by 2 is the multiplicative inverse of 2 by 3. Multiplicative inverse of 2 by 3. So simply you say that when you take the A and find the additive multiplicative inverse of A is multiplicative inverse of A is 1 by A. A is 1 by A. When you take the 1 by A, multiplicative inverse of 1 by A is A. 1 by A is A. Here, I am taking A as 7. What the multiplicative inverse of A? 1 by A. So that means 1 by A. So here I am taking the 2 by 3. So 2 by 3, what is the value of? First of all, 2 by 3 is A. So what is the value of 1 by A? So the reciprocal of the product, that means 3 by 2. Okay. So can I ask questions? Okay. Right. So what is the multiplicative inverse of 3 by 4? Very good. 4 by 3. Sorry. But 3 by 4. Multiplicative inverse of 3 by 4 is 4 by 3. So what is the multiplicative inverse of 2 by 7? Very good. 7 by 2. So multiplicative inverse of 2 by 7 is 7 by 2. Okay. So these are the properties of rational numbers. Okay, so next we move the another property, so that is distributive property. Okay, students, so next we move the another property, so that is distributive property. Distributive property. Okay, so before going to distributive property, so I explain that. So first, of course, you and your brother go to market. When your brother go to market and buy the some pens. First suppose the two brothers' names are Ramu, Ravi. Okay. First suppose Ramu buys 4 pens. Ramu buys 4 pens. With the cost 10 rupees. With the cost 10 rupees. That means each pen have cost 10 rupees. But suppose Ravi buys 5 pens with the cost of 1 pen. 10 rupees. With the cost of 1 pen is equal to 10. That means so both are by the pen is the cost of 10 rupees. But here Ramu buys 4 and Ravi buys 5. Okay. So in general, what is the sum of the amount they pay to shop? What is the sum of amount they pay to shop? How to calculate that? So in general, how to calculate that? So here Ramu buys 4 pens with the cost of 10, that means so 4 into 10, that means 40. That means Ramu spent 40 rupees on the pens. So what about Ravi? So Ravi spend the amount to the shopkeeper as well. Nine. So in general we have to. For example. Okay. For example. So after for example I say that. So here the cost will be the same. So that means I can write the cost will be right as same. That means the cost will be multiplied. The cost will be multiplied. Some of the two persons buy the pens. Okay. So Ram buys how many pens?
Four.
So Ravi buys how many pens?
Five.
So that means 10 into. So what is 4 plus 5?
9.
So 10 into 9. So it becomes
90.
Okay. So when you find the value, here also got 90. When you find the cost will be unique. And the buying two pens we have take like that. Okay. It also gives 90 rupees. By observing this one, okay, so we have to write as here the cost will be write as A. The unit cost will be write as A into, so take the two persons value as B plus C is equal to, it gives A into B plus A into C. So this is called distributive property under multiplication over addition. Distributive property under multiplication over addition. Again I repeat it. Distributive property under multiplication over addition. Over addition. So that means A into B plus C is equal to A into B plus A into C. So it is the distributive property under multiplication over addition. Okay, so distributive have two properties, that is under addition and again subtraction also. So that is A into B minus C. A into B minus C is equal to A into B minus A into C. A into B minus A into C. Here we say that distributive property under multiplication over subtraction. Distributive property under multiplication over subtraction. So these two are the properties of distributive property. Okay, so now we have to take example and prove the distributive property, how it will be work. Okay. Okay, so consider the example of distributive property under multiplication over addition. Okay, under multiplication over. So A is equal to, I take 2, B is equal to 3, C is equal to 5. So any 3 rational numbers. Okay, so here A, B, C, for all A, B, C belongs to 2. Because A, B, C belongs to B means belongs to indicate the those 3 elements in the rational number set. Okay. So what is A value? So first do the LHS side. So what is A value? 2 into in brackets. So what is B value? 3 plus what is C value? 5. So whenever you done on that, so first we done the in bracket values. In bracket values. What is the in bracket values? 2 plus 5. 3 plus 5. That means it gives 8. 2 8 is 6. So this is LHS. So coming to RHS. So what is RHS? A into B plus A into C. So what is A value? So what is B value? 3 plus what is A value? 2 and what is C value? 5. So what is 2 into 3? 6. Very good. Plus what is 2 into 5? 10. Very good. So what is the value of 6 plus 10? It gives 16. So that means here LHS gives 16. RHS gives 16. That means LHS is equal to RHS. Okay. LHS is equal to RHS. So this is the distributive property under multiplication over addition. Very good. So next up, distributive property under multiplication over subtraction, we do the example. Okay. A into, so over subtraction what we do? A minus B. B minus C is equal to A into B minus A into C. Okay. So this is called distributive property under multiplication over subtraction. So again same examples you have to consider. So I can tell the same values. Okay. So that means so LHS side. What is A value? 2. Into what is B value? 3. Minus what is C value? 5. Okay. So 2 into, so what is the value? value of 3 minus 5, it is not possible. That will be 5 minus 3, so that gives 2. So here I square your sign minus, that means minus 2. So 2 into minus 2, that gives minus 4. So about RHS. So what is the value of A? So it gives 2. What is B value? 3. Minus. What is A value? 2. What is C value? 5. So that means 2 into 3, that is 6. Minus 2 into 5, so that is 10. So 6 minus 10 is not possible. 10 minus 6, that is 4. So here I square indicates minus 4. That means minus 4. So by observing this, LHS is equal to RHS. So LHS is equal to RHS. So this is the property of distributive property under multiplication over subtraction. Okay, so how can you understand that? So we have to better understanding. For better understanding, we have to take the tips, your own example. So we have to learn on the problems. Okay, so in next class, we discuss about the. So another problem.